Very basically, obviously the computer is the hub of everything. I don't have a desk, so it's more of a sort of modular setup, I suppose you'd call it. I've got quite a lot of hardware, so quite a few synths, quite a few mono synths and three or four poly synths, which are all running into a kind of multi-channel interface and are all being controlled by a separate MIDI interface. And that's all running into Ableton with, you know, via several pedals or whatever. I mean, I record and compose everything in Ableton, and then once I get to a certain point, I will bounce it all and start working completely in audio in Pro Tools, and I'll tweak everything and kind of mix everything in Pro Tools. I just changed the way I approach the music, and you sort of open yourself up to errors and imperfections in a way that I was, like, possibly as a producer, scared of doing. And I think people who start on computers are scared of doing. You think, you know, you can't just kind of let everything go mad and hit record. You have to get it until it's perfect and then you bounce it. And that's not the way you should. You know, I found it really liberating to just hit record straight away, get the audio down, find the bits that I like, and kind of mesh them together into something, into a kind of way more interesting whole that doesn't sound as sterile. It's got errors all over the place, like timing imperfections, you know, bits where the delay kind of goes a bit mental, or you unplug something by mistake and it makes a funny noise in the reverb. Those are all kind of special moments that sometimes that sound great on a record if you include them. So it's just about opening yourself up to those moments, because you miss them. You miss them if it's all in the computer and the record isn't running. I wouldn't pretend to know all of the capabilities of the instruments that I've got. That's why I'm not buying loads of more synthesizers. But you have to get to a certain point where you have to spend a few days with it, and you have to know, okay, great, this actually makes really cool bass lines, or I didn't realise you can actually make a cool snare with this, or you can make nice hi-hats, bell sounds, does the filter self-resonate, you know, all these kind of cool little tricks, because those are the things that end up making you sound different, because there's a certain element of overlap between all synths. Not all synths, but, you know, between a lot of mono synths. So here's an example. I mean, the MS-20, the 101, the Pro 1, which isn't in here, and the Moog. There are certain sounds which you could make with all of them, which would be roughly, even the filter sounds are different, but they'd be rough, more or less similar. But then it's finding out what the sounds are with each mono synth that only that mono synth can do, that only can be achieved with that. So if you want things that are really, really kind of aggressive and metallic and bite, which are really good for lead sounds, then the MS-20 kills it on that. And the 101 can sound a bit bland. And the Moog especially sounds completely tame in comparison. But if you want something which just completely fills the bottom end, then it has to be the Moog. If you want those kind of one note sustained bass lines, then the Moog is the one, really, or, you know, in my studio, or the Pro one. So you have to find out what the capabilities are of these things, and it's not always what you thought. I mean, the unexpected things are the cool things. Have to do more than just the synthesizer to make them sound interesting often. I mean, I think that's something that people forget. A 909 on its own sounds crap. You know, it sounds like a toy. And I think a lot of people are quite disappointed these days when they buy a 909 and they think it's gonna be like this magic thing where you kind of hit the bass drum and it goes, you know, the speakers explode and something like that happens. You have to treat it. You have to push it. That's what, you know, you have to find good preamps or you have to find some bit of gear to push it through to give it that sound that people really, really like. I've got some Neve clones, a couple of Neve clones, and then I've got a Universal Audio kind of four-track in that goes in via the ADAT into my interface. That's one of the things, you know, album two, that's going to get updated. Because preamps make such a huge difference. The preamps, you know, if I could say to anybody, if you're like buying an interface, just don't worry too much about what the preamps are like on it. All preamps on all interfaces are shit. If you want decent preamps, buy decent preamps. And you should care more about the ADDA conversion on an interface, really. And that's something that took me quite a while to work out. You know, a lot of these companies boast about how good their preamps are, but the most you can really hope for is that they're quite transparent. If you want to get some character out of a preamp, then you should buy like a tube preamp or like a preamp with, you know, the Great River things. I mean, I'm gonna get some Great River things. The problem is that's when it starts getting really, really expensive and complicated. You know, I don't want a big desk. So I think max I'd kind of want four channels of really, really nice preamps, and I don't think I'd need anything else. Getting to the point of, like, I feel of diminishing returns. Like, once I have a better interface, I have preamps, you're starting to spend a lot of money on minute differences. At the beginning, the differences are big, and then, as with all high-end stuff, you're paying €1,000 more for 5% difference or 3% difference. And that can seem like a lot, but sometimes you have to step back and just be like, I don't really need it. Is it helping me musically? No, it's not. So I'm just going to leave it. But yeah, I think moving into that kind of modular thing and then having a big patch-based system so I can kind of create more interesting tones or have more flexibility in kind of tone with preamps and compressors and EQs, that's the next step for me.